We have a wonderful children's service now in the upper rooms. So if there is any child left here, can join the other group. Not those who feel like children, but we speak about the real children's age. And this does not relate to those who know that they are children of God. This concerns those who are in children's age. Shabbat Shalom. It's a very special Shabbat today. I can hardly grasp it, how special this Shabbat is. The first Shabbat that we are not obliged to wear masks anymore and come back to normal. And the first Shabbat where we are not obliged to keep distance all the time. It doesn't mean that we do not have the right to wear masks. Everybody is free to wear masks. But those who do not want to wear masks, it has a meaning. We are not talking about medicine now, but about a special freedom that we have. For 2 years now, we were not able to gather here in a normal way. For 2 years now, we could not really breathe properly while we were here. And for 2 years, people have told me we cannot come to the gatherings, to the Shabbat, because we cannot, we are not able to wear masks all the time. But now it's finished, and now people can come back. For 2 years and a few weeks, we have lived in such a way. We have been living with all these regulations. Many have not remembered how we looked before, and also before Corona, the congregation was fuller, was more complete. But many of those who came before Corona, they are not here today. So if you continue sitting on your sofas at home, Shalom, we are happy that you at least follow us, watch us online. If you are not in Berlin and following us via internet online, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord that we can be connected through the internet. But when you are here in Berlin, you are very welcome to come to our service or to visit us. For the first time, for 2 years, we are not obliged to keep visitors lists. You remember you had to register before, even last Saturday, it was like this, that we had to register if we wanted to come to the service. We were reduced to 35 participants, 35 visitors, not more were allowed. And yesterday, André said, I don't know how it was keeping Shabbat or coming to Shabbat without lists. If you want to come spontaneously, you can get up from your sofa at home. You can come and participate and worship with us. But remember, please remember that during prayers and during worship time, you cannot enter the hall, but in between worship time and prayers. So those of you who know us from before COVID, that is the entrance that he is showing. And here are all eyes watching on this person in the front. And everybody who is entering this hall looks almost like a bridegroom or a bride. Ah, who is coming? Who is again coming? How nice. So the visitors walking through this synagogue, like the American president, almost. This is why we have said during prayer time and during worship time, it's not allowed to enter the hall, but in between. We are remembering again how it was before Corona. Our congregation is being renewed. There are new people in our congregation. I don't want to say other people, but new people have joined our congregation. Because we do not want to replace those who have been with us before. Because all of those sisters and brothers who have been here with us before COVID are very precious to us, very precious to us. But a new time has begun for our congregation, for our worship time, for our worship services, for our ministry. And if something new is beginning, or if something new is being revealed, you remember when there is a new building built and inaugurated, there is a ribbon that has been to cut. It has to be cut. He's demonstrating. Yeah. I have some scissors here, pair of scissors. And I will cut a ribbon now. A ribbon on a chair. Do you see these red and white ribbons? These were to mark the chairs in order to show people where they are allowed to sit and where it has to be free. So this is what I'm doing now, is symbolically. We have been using these marks for 2 years. And when I cut these sellotapes, these ribbons, we proclaim something new is beginning. So if you like to cut these ribbons, then you are welcome to do it after the service. And proclaim a new time has begun as a renewal of life. So I will demonstrate this now. Are you ready? Praise the Lord.
Alleluia.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And now we will come back to the Bible, to the Word of God. From now on, we can come together in a normal way. But now the question is asked, for what purpose we need these gatherings, these worship services? Why should we come together here on Shabbat? And here I'm reminded of a question that I asked my leader from former times when I was a young believer. Together with my wife Ina, we came to Berlin many years ago and we started with this worship services every Shabbat. And I felt so lonely at that time, because there was nothing there at that time. And I think it was the first summer when we were here in Berlin to start with worship services. Imagine, in Germany there are hardly any messianic movements. And the churches I knew, Christian churches I came to know at that time, they were not so friendly to us, they didn't really love us. And in the whole of Germany, you could count on one hand how many messianic believers or servants were living here. And I remember sitting in my room at home and was so lonely. I felt like a lemon that was empty. I didn't remember anyone with whom I could have fellowship, and André and Sveta at that time had not yet come to Berlin. And I remember I went on my knees and I cried out to God, I'm not able to continue, I cannot do it anymore, do something, Lord. Help us, Lord. And then the Lord brought me to someone with whom I could have fellowship. This person for me was like a mentor or a leader. And you have to understand, at that time I was just was a new believer just for 2 years, something like that. But the Lord used me at that time already to set up 3 congregations, or to help founding three new congregations. But for the first time in my life, I was in a new country. Fortunately, my wife was with me. Of course, we were together. Otherwise, I wouldn't have survived it, to be here alone. And when I started having fellowship with this new friend, at least I had some fellowship. Then another messianic believer or believer asked me the same question, why should we go to a congregation and to a worship service at all? Why should we do that? And so I asked my new friend with whom I had fellowship, and he told me about one verse from the letter to the Hebrews.
Im 25. Vers. Viele von euch kennen diese Stelle. Auch ich kannte sie damals. Hier steht geschrieben.
Chapter 10, verse 25, in the letter to the Hebrews.
Indem wir unsere eigene Versammlung nicht verlassen, wie es einige zu tun pflegen.
He told me, see, this is written here, not forsaking our own assembling together, as it is the habit of some. And you find all that we should do with each other, or how we should behave with each other, you find in many places in the New Testament. We need this. We need each other, encouraging one another. I understand why I could not live in this spiritual loneliness at that time. At that time, it was very hard for me to be alone in the very beginning, because the Almighty God has created us in such a way to have fellowship with each other, and He created the people of Israel in such a way. And the Most High God created all believers in Yeshua like this. Not only from the very creation of the world, He didn't say it's not good to be alone and talking about husband and wife, but God created man with this longing inside to be together with others. This desire is so strong in us to have fellowship with others that sometimes it led to sin. And the Most High God said, you can fill all the whole world. But the people at that time wanted to set up a monument to worship. And this was not pleasing God. And this is another topic why this happened in such a way. But deep inside us, we have this deep longing which has been created by God to be together with others. But at that time, the Lord had to mix the cultures and languages because of the sin that happened at the Tower of Babel. And because people sinned. And you know how it is in our congregation. Russian-speaking people keep together, German-speaking people keep together to be on time or not on time, eating in such a way, culturally or in another way. So, fellowship in different ways. And since 2006, we have been talking about these things, and in spite of these differences, we are together. Because this longing and this need to be in community, to be in a fellowship, people are not created to be external, to be outside of a community. This is why it is written in scriptures. So it's not written that you must be in a community, but you should be in the community of believers. It says be wise, not only be together with any people, be wise in choosing fellowship with others. When the Lord created Israel, he made them as one people. He created them as one people. The people of Israel is one people. And this people had to be together. Every one for each other. They had to be together, depending on each other and needing each other, helping each other. This people could invite guests, but had to live according to certain rules. But the people of Israel had to choose with whom they wanted to be together, with whom from other peoples they should be together. Do you remember? Do you remember when the Lord says, "And in this way, wipe out every evil from your midst"? Concerning certain sins, it is written in the Torah to wipe out the evil. But it was not meant death as punishment in the first place, but the individual lost the possibility to have fellowship, to be included in this fellowship. So we, as human beings, we need fellowship. But it's so important that we are in the right way, in the right fellowship, in the right gathering, where there are certain rules and where we behave in a certain way. And this is especially concerning our faith. This is why it is written in the New Testament, in the Messianic scriptures, again and again, be together and separate yourself from sin. Do not have anything with sinful life or sinful gatherings, but be among your own, or be together with those with the same way of living according to your faith. We are still living in the world. We are the light of the world. In this world, we are a testimony in this world, but at the same way, the same time, we know where our fellowship and assembling together has to be. When the followers of Yeshua lived together, like in the book of Acts, other people looked at them and they said, "Wow, we also want to live in the same way." And the Most High God gave more and more people, and more people joined. Mm-hmm.
derjenigen, die die Tora gelesen haben, ist das nicht genau das, was der Herr von Israel wollte?
And those who have read the Torah, isn't this exactly what the Lord wanted the people of Israel wanted to do, to live justfully, rightfully? And when you live in this way, rightfully, other people will look up to you and will see your example and your testimony, and they want to copy you, they want the same. That's what we see in the Book of Acts. Like in the future it will be perfect. The people of Israel will believe in the Mashiach. The Holy Spirit will fulfill the people of Israel in the future, and all Jews will gather together to praise him, to the king, and to worship the Messiah, and all other peoples, nations will join Israel, will come to Israel. They will grab every Israelite or Jew and ask him, lead us, lead our church or congregation. In the same way, other messianic churches or a good Christian church, they should really develop into such communities, fellowships, so that other people see them. No matter if they are Jews or not Jews, or Christians, so that others will say, I want to be there. That's a fellowship where the Lord is present. That's a community where the Lord is moving. This is why it is so important that we gather together, that we have fellowships, that we assemble together, because the Lord is with us here. In the way how the Lord has created us. He has created us in such a way so that we are together with others, but it should be in the right way, in a good way. And what we have been reading here in the letter to the Hebrews, I want to read in its context. I start reading from verse 23, chapter 10, verse 23. Or we start with 22 up to verse 25. Let us draw near with a sincere heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how to stimulate one another to love and good deeds, not forsaking our own assembling together, as it is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near.
Denn ist treu, der die Verheißung gegeben hat. Und lasst uns aufeinander Acht geben, damit wir uns gegenseitig anspornen zu Liebe und zu guten Werken. Indem wir unsere eigene Versammlung nicht verlassen, wie es einige zu tun pflegen, sondern einander ermahnen, und das umso mehr, als ihr den Tag herannahen seht. Und danach ist die Rede davon, wie gefährlich es ist, wenn man vom Glauben abfällt.
And after these verses, the scriptures talk how dangerous it is to fall off the faith, or to leave the faith, or to leave the gospel, how terrifying it is. And in this context we see on this verse, do not leave your assembly, do not forsake it. And to live in such a way helps us to endure and to remain in right in the right teachings, and to endure in faith, to hold fast the confession of our hope. Because without these gatherings and coming together, there is a danger to be seduced to other lives. Of course you can follow us online, at home, on your sofa, through videos, but this will never replace real life in the community. Don't forsake the assembly. Do not live without gathering, without assembly of the believers. Where people people who could do not be without people who could stimulate you or encourage you or remind you of keeping your faith. And do not be without gatherings and people for whom you could be an example. There is no Jew apart from the people of Israel, and there is no believer without an assembly. Be together with others in an assembly and participate in worship service not only through the internet. If you like our worship services but you live far from Berlin, this is wonderful, but this is not all. This is not really the ideal situation. You can follow us, worship with us, praise the Lord, and you can virtually feel the unity. But go out and find an assembly, a gathering of believers, where you can join there where you live. The internet cannot replace this. We have to know each other so that we can live with each other and encourage each other. Hundreds of people watch us via internet, and I don't know them. I do not know everybody of you following us through the internet. And many of those here in this congregation don't know all people who are watching us. How can we help you? Only through preaching, that's what I'm doing. But I cannot be like an influencer, so that I can take you with me in all areas of my life. I cannot show you, oh, look what I'm doing, what I'm about to eat, or I have bought something new, I want to show you, or I I'm running along this beach. This is not really being together. This is as if I invite you to a show of myself, but this will not help you. We can come to know each other and serve each other, but only when we are with each other, then we are able in the best way to endure and to keep our faith. And you know what is written in Proverbs. You know that a threefold cord, it's almost impossible to cut it or to rip it apart. And you know that it is written, if one is lying alone, it's cold, but when two are together, that they are warming up each other. Is this a commandment? No, but it's how the Lord has created us. A lonely believer, it's not only sad, that is against God's nature. This is unnatural. It should not be like this. It's not supposed to be like this. Even if you cannot be in your church or congregation because of the circumstances of your life, but you should really look for a congregation, for a fellowship where you can meet with other believers, because it's dangerous to stay alone and it can even harm your health. It's not the question that you should be together with anybody, but the question is that you are together with the right people and that you will be wise to choose the right fellowship, the fellowship of believers, the fellowship of believers that follow Yeshua. And if you are a messianic believer, that then it's the messianic congregation or movement that is following Yeshua. And another verse closing this sermon, I want to mention another. Matthew chapter 18. Matthew chapter 18. From verse 18 till verse 20. And what I'm going to read now is connected with the text before, where it's talking about how to solve conflicts. If you are offended, to whom you should go, for instance. By the way, when you are offended, where should you go? To whom should you go first? You should go to the person who has offended you. Go to the person who offended you and tell him or her. If you see that someone is sinning, to whom you go? At the first place, in the first place. Our main rabbi, Yeshua, has told us, go to the person who has sinned against you or whom you see has sinned.
And if he is not listening to you or she, then come with other witnesses. And even then, when the person, the sinner, is not listening, you can go to the elders. But when the sinner is listening to you, then you have one friend. In verse 15 it says, if your brother sins, if you talk to another brother or sister who sins, gives the possibility that you win a friend. This is why Yeshua talks about this in the scriptures. And from verse 18, truly I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be been loosed in heaven, shall have been loosed in heaven. Again I say to you, that if two of you agree on earth about anything that they may ask, it shall be done for them by my Father who is in heaven. For where two or three have gathered together in my name, I am there in the midst. Imagine what a power this is when we are coming together. Here Yeshua is relating to a very old Jewish tradition. If two sit together and in between they have the words of the Torah, that's the Shekinah, that's the glory of God with them. Here Yeshua underlines and stresses that he is greater than the Torah. He is the glory of God, of the Lord. He is the Shekinah of the Lord. If there are two or three gathered together in his name, then their prayers can be heard. And sometimes people do not pay attention to what is written in verse 20. Where? The word where, that can be in Zoom, can be on the telephone, could even be on YouTube, but nothing can replace the geographical being together, the geographical gathering. We are together in a messianic synagogue here together with you. It's a wonderful place. It's like a mirror. It's like a picture of the Lord, the presence of the Lord on earth. Israel gathered through the Lord. Israel gathered together through the Lord, and we have the Messiah with us, with all of us gathered together. This is why this is like some complete Israel, something. Those gathered together around the Lord with the Messiah in their midst is like something like complete Israel, a perfect Israel. And what do you know? What is written on the top of the wall? No. Remember where you are standing, before whom you are standing. And when we come to this place, into this synagogue, we know this. And we say, be welcome, Baruch Haba Yeshua. The geographical point is here in Berlin, where we can gather together and assemble together. There are many places, worship places, many wonderful worship places in Berlin and wonderful congregations in Berlin. And everybody can choose where he wants to go or she. Or even start with a new congregation. Choose your congregation. You are free to choose your congregation, but do not stay alone. Because it's not natural to stay alone as a believer. It's unhealthy physically and spiritually, especially spiritually. And for your spiritual health, it is important to assemble together. And now the ribbon has been cut. A new era has begun. The limitations have gone. So let us be together. If it's necessary, through the internet, but still even better, it is to be gathered together in one place. In our place, in our synagogue, or wherever the Lord leads you to go. We praise Yeshua that he has spread his holy blood and that he died for us and rose from the dead and forgave us our sins so that we can start a new life with him. And that he went to heaven and sent us his Holy Spirit to fill us and to found a congregation in one spirit, to establish a congregation in one spirit. Years ago, he decided that we should gather together here with all its mistakes and with all its advantages to establish a congregation in this place. And he will help us to bring us this congregation on a new level. Stay in Yeshua and stay with a fellowship. Amen. Shiru, 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 shiru